So hi guys, in this video tutorial playlist, I'm going to talk about quantitative aptitude. So starting with the number system. Before going to tell you about number system, I want to tell about the process through which you can deduce your calculation step. So starting with the addition. I know you all guys know about addition system, but check it out. The way you do really reduces the time, and the way you should do that reduce your time. Suppose you want to add two number, that is 56 plus 78. What is the first thought process we actually do? We do is 56 plus 78, 8 plus 6, 14, carry per 1, 5, 7 plus 5, 12, carry per 1, 13, 134. This is the process through which we do our calculation. But in exams, there are lots of calculation. If for every calculation we do through this way, then it will take time. And now I'm going to tell you the process that you should do that will really reduce your time. Just check it out. Suppose you want to add this two number, 56 plus 78. We are always good with the addition of a single digit. Suppose I want to add 56 plus 78, just do it simple. 6 plus 78, we know it's 84. After adding 50 to 84, we know 50 plus 80 is 130. So directly getting 134. So now talking about multiplication. What is the right way through which we should multiply the two numbers and to reduce our time? Suppose we want to add two number, multiply two number, that is 48 into 56. What we generally do is to do like this, 48 into 56, 6 8s are 48, carry per 4, 6 4s are 24 plus 4, 28, then cross 40, carry per 4, 5 4s are 20 plus 4, 24, then 8, 8, 6, 2. This is the way through which we do the calculation. And what is the right way through which we should do the calculation to save our time? It is simple. We know that 6 8s are 48, 8 carry per 4. Then multiply this number with this number and this number with this number and add the two number and add this number. Let's see. 8 5s are 40, 6 4s are 24. 40 plus 24, 64. 64 plus 4, 68. 8. Now write 6 here. Now simply multiply this number and this number. 4 into 5, 20. 20 plus 6, 26. See, you can reduce your time. Now talking about HCF. What is HCF? HCF is our highest common factor. How to calculate HCF of two numbers? Suppose I have a two number, 27 and 24. Then what is the HCF of these two numbers? 27, that is 3 raised to power 3. And what is 24? That is 2 raised to power 3 into 3. We should always write the numbers in the prime factorization way. Then what is the common factors that these two have? As we are saying, only 3 is common. So HCF of these two numbers is 3. These two numbers are small, so doing HCF is comparatively easy through this way. But does this way is actually making you fast calculation or not? No. Now what is the right way that we should do the HCF of the two numbers, or calculate how to calculate the HCF of two numbers? Let's see. Always take out the difference between these two numbers, or any two numbers. Suppose what is the difference between 24 and 27? It's 3. So your answer is 3. Now suppose we want to find the HCF of these three numbers, 62, 186 and 279. So what is the right way that we should calculate the HCF of the three numbers? Is that way to calculate the factors of 62, then calculate the factor of 186 and then calculate the factor of 279 and then taking out common? Then it will take much time. Now what is the right way? Take out the difference. And only the difference that is smallest of the three numbers. I know the difference between them would be approximately 124, and the difference between these two numbers, as I have already told you how to do the calculation, we are always good with a small digit. 279 minus 6, 273. 273 minus 80, 193. And 193 minus 100, that is 93. So the difference between these two numbers is 93. Then our HCF should be the factor of this number. Either it should be 93 or factor of 93. Obviously 62 is there, so 93 will not be our answer. So now prime factorizing this, 31 into 3, that is 93. Is this divisible by 62? Is 62 divisible by 3? Just check it out. No, it's not. If 3 is not divisible by 62, then 31, yes, 31, it is divisible by this. And we are seeing 186. Yes, 31 into 6 is 186. And obviously, this number is 31 into 9. So we can directly say the factor of these three numbers is 31. This reduces our time. So this is the right way through which we should do the calculate the HCF of the three numbers. So how in exams the question generally comes is like this. Find the highest number which divide 675, 645 and 635 and will give the common remainder. Matlab, when we divide these three numbers with a particular number, we are going to get a common remainder that we have to find. So this type of question generally come to the HCF. How? Because we have to find the highest number. Highest number. Are you getting? We need to find a factor that divides this, this and this and will to leave a same remainder. We know how to calculate the HCF of these three numbers. 675, 645 and 630. If we do the So how to calculate the HCF of these three numbers that I have already told you, just calculate the difference and the smallest difference would be the answer or the factor of the smallest answer. What is the difference between these two numbers? 15. These two numbers? 15. And difference between these two numbers? 45. So we know the smallest difference is 15. Then the factor should be 15. Then the answer should be 15 or the factor of 15, that is 5 into 3. We know 15 completely divide 675, 645 and 630. So directly by seeing, we can say the answer is 15. This reduces our time. So in exams on HCF, the second type of question that comes on like this. We know about HCF into LCM equals to product of two numbers. Let's check it out the problem on this. So in exam, next type of question that comes on HCF is, we are given HCF of two number is 11 and their LCM is 616 and one of the number is 88, then we are asked what is the second number. We know the formula, HCF into LCM equals to product of two number. We know HCF is given as 11 and LCM as 616 and one of the number is given 88, then we can easily find P2. So this is the second category of the question that is asked in the HCF. A miscellaneous type of a question which generally comes in exam sometimes. So how to calculate the HCF of these two numbers, 3 raised to power 125 minus 1 and 3 raised to power 35 minus 1. The process is simple. HCF of these two numbers is simply HCF of 3 raised to power 125 and 35 minus 1. Now we can easily calculate the HCF of 125 and 35. How? We know the difference between this number, that is 95. Now it should be the factor of 95 and we all are as seeing the answer would be 5. Now coming to LCM, we all know what is LCM. LCM is a lowest common multiple. Lowest common multiple means what are the common multiples
that the two numbers can have. Suppose I have two numbers 12 and 14, then what will be the LCM of these two numbers? 12 we can write as 2 raised to power 2 into 3 and 2 raised to power 1 into 7 raised to power 1. So we know taking out common 2, 3 and 7 and 2, this would be the LCM of the two number. Now in exams, the questions of LCM don't generally come up. They don't ask you about find the LCM of 24, 48. So the in LCM category, they generally ask the question like this type. Suppose there are two clocks which rings at 50 seconds and 40 seconds respectively, then find out the time when they are going to ring out simultaneously. So look at this question. These are the category of questions that generally comes in LCM category. So we know first clocks ring at 50 seconds, then second clock ring at 48 seconds, then calculate the LCM of these two numbers. We know it's simple, 5 square into 2, 48. We know 48, it is 24 into 2, and 24 is 8 into 3, and 8 is 2 raised to power 3, and 2 is 2 raised to power 4 into 3. So what would be the LCM of these two numbers? As you are seeing, 2 raised to power 4 into 3 into 5 square. After calculating this value, we are going to get our answer. Now second category of questions which generally comes in LCM is this. We need to find the smallest 3 digit number which when divided by 15, 20 and 30 leaves a remainder of 11. So how we are going to differentiate whether this question is of LCM or LCF? It's simple. See what it is really asking you. Smallest 3 digit number which when divided by 15, 20 and 30 leaves a remainder of 11. Means the number which we want to get should be divided by 15 as well as 20, and it must also be divisible by 30. So clearly a number which is divisible by 15, 20 and 30 will definitely will be the multiple of these three numbers. Then we know how to calculate the LCM of this number 15, 20 and 30. We know the LCM of these three numbers is going to be 60. Now what it is asking is smallest 3 digit number. So we know our LCM is 60, but this 60 is a 2 digit number. Then factor of 60, that is 120. Now this would be the smallest number that will be divisible by 50, 20 and 30. But what we actually want, that it should leave a remainder of 11. Then add 120 plus 11, this is 131. So our answer is 131.